Came in fresh as livery, Miss Martin, so I run it over quick. Thought maybe it might be what you were expecting.
It is, thanks.
Well, is it good or do we...
We don't. They're throwing me out and a new owner's coming in. Read it.
New York Probate Court, where the terms of this will dated... Say, who is this Rodney T. Blackton?
It's a new will, and Rodney T. Blackton's a new owner. Well, Jim, it looks as though you're out of a job.
You leaving too, Miss Martin?
Not if I can help it. I'm going to hang on here till they tell me to leave. But I'll be closing the books on the help. Tell them to come in and I'll pay them off. Well, that's it. It's pretty short notice, boys, but they didn't give me any either. Might try some of the other ranches. Maybe they can use you there.
What about the new owner? He's not closing the place down, is he?
That's his business, Jim. Personally, I don't care what he does with it. If I were you, I wouldn't count too much on getting your jobs back. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye, Miss Martin.
Good luck, boys.
Bye.
Well, all washed up, eh, Jim?
That's right, Mr. Jackson. I've been paid off. Anything doing on your ranch?
Afraid not this time of year. Up, aren't we, Bart?
Yeah, I'm afraid so until fall, anyhow. I'll look us up then, Jim.
Sorry. Mind if I come in?
No. Hello, Greg.
Just heard the bad news. Hope you'll forgive me, but I can't help saying I told you so, Vera.
All right, Greg, have your fun. Frankly, I don't feel very funny about it.
Well, what are you going to do? Give up?
I'm not sure. I never figured there was another will. That's what you get for trusting an old man like Bagley. Why, even up to the end before he died...
I know. He told you the place was yours, and I told you then you were a sucker. So you see what happens. All you get after these years of keeping house and being a slave is a... letter of apology from the lawyers. Well, who is the heir?
His nephew. Some Easterner.
An Easterner? Just a minute. I just had a thought.
What kind of a thought?
See that creek?
Yes.
That's your property, or was. As a matter of fact, that's the best feature this place has. Where's that map? I've got an angle, and I'll need your help. Only this time you do as I say. Do you understand?
Marry you?
Now, don't rush me. One thing at a time. Right now, I've got another sort of partnership in mind. You know, I've got a hunch this new owner is going to sell me this piece of property cheap. Shall I tell you why?
No, let me guess why. You're going to do something to that stream, aren't you?
Bagby gave you a raw deal, didn't he? How would you like a square deal for a change?
What do you think?
All right, now you're getting smart. When is this nephew arriving?
He's on his way, I guess.
Well, I'll have to cut some corners then. But you do it my way. Keep that in mind.
I will.
Get in, drive. Hurry up.
What's the rush?
I'll tell you about it on the way.
Home?
No, Grace Canyon. Shake it up. Grab a shovel, Bart. Not bad, huh?
Yeah, if it holds.
It'll hold. Long enough to make a desert out of this Bagley ranch. A week's all I need. And luck.
About a couple of tall ones. I'll buy and we'll drink the luck.
All right.
Say, have a look. Some sort of a roundup.
A funny time of night to be working cows.
Funny country. Everything going to pot. People working day and night. Makes you sick to think of it, doesn't it, Gabby?
Not on an empty stomach, it don't. I'm almost hungry enough to try it.
What's eating you, Roy?
That herd. They're moving them through the fence, making their gates as they go. Boys, let's clear out of here.
What about the cattle?
Listen, I'm playing safe. We'll come back and get them later. Boy, that was close.
Those confounded animals. You all right, miss?
I'm okay.
The steering rod's bent. There's a house down the road a piece. If they've got a phone, I'll send for the truck. Might take me an hour, though, walking both ways.
I guess I'll just have to wait.
I'll be as quick as I can.
Oh, by the way, would you please try and get him some milk? This young man's getting pretty hungry.
I'll do my best, miss. Just you sit tight and don't worry.
Thank you. This isn't a holdup. I'll pay for the milk. Bossy, stay right there now. Nice, Bossy.
You hurt?
No, thank you.
Well, that sounded like a child. Have you a baby, miss?
Oh, he's not really mine. I'm his guardian, but I'm responsible for him, if that's what you mean. That's how I got all tangled up. I was trying to get some milk for him. Where'd that cow go?
You mean that critter over there?
Yes, the silly thing. I wasn't going to steal the milk. I only wanted to borrow enough for the baby. Hey, maybe you gentlemen will help me.
Milk that cow?
Of course. That's what a cow is for, isn't it? What's so strange about that?
I'm afraid it's kind of hard to explain, miss. You see, there are cows and there are cows. Some of them you can milk, and some of them you can't catch. Well, that happens to be the kind you can't catch. What were you going to put the milk in? I'm afraid you're going to have to do better than that.
Besides, it'd take maybe five to hold her down.
Well, there seems to be five of you here. You look like a man.
Who, me?
Of course, it's kind of dark, and I can't be sure. But I have an idea you could milk that cow all by yourself, if you try.
Alone? All by myself? Well, maybe you could. You know, I'm pretty strong.
Oh, thanks a lot. I'll get the baby and have him all ready.
Get the baby? But, he's a bottle baby. You better get a pail.
I'm proud of you, Gabby.
We're all proud of you, Gabby. Well, what are you waiting for?
Waiting for? Nothing, I guess. The pail.
Oh, we'll take care of that. In the meantime, you better go catch the cow.
Well, I ain't so sure about that, Roy. Maybe I talk too much.
Oh, that's all right, Gabby. You're going to back up your words with great deeds. Goodbye, old boy. I mean, good luck.
Here I go, doggone.
Boys, and head her off.
Is this all Bagley Ranch?
It seems to be. See those lights? That must be the ranch house. They're expecting you, aren't they?
Well, yes, I think so. But I'm not so sure we'll be very welcome. You see, I'm really coming to take possession of the place.
You mean you own it?
Well, not exactly. The young man there is the owner. The baby, he's the owner.
This? Well, I'll be doggone in cactus bit.
Day is done and evening finds me home by the fire. Let me stay. Turn the lights down low, let the shadows glow on the wall, see the flame, dance and sway. What a joy divine, this peace of mind to dream by the fire in the day. When the nightingale comes winging to his wild world of, and the sandman he comes singing down the moonbeam trail above, growing sand in sleepy eyes, till the world of sorrow dies, and old friends meet in slumber sweet to a sandman.
I guess this is the place. Somebody's home, too.
I won't say goodbye to him now, miss. Might wake him up. Besides, I'm all out of lullabies. But it was sure nice meeting both of you.
Is there anything else we can do?
Well, maybe there is. Would you mind waiting till I meet these people? Will you come inside with me?
Do you think it's all right with the owner?
I'm sure of it.
Come on, boys. We're invited inside.
See you, it is, Sam.
Yes, ma'am. That's probably him. Now remember what I told you.
I will.
Is Mr. Rodney Blackton to see you, Miss Barton?
Thank you. I'm Vera Martin. Mr. Blackton, we've been expecting you. I thought you were an Easterner.
Oh, but my name's Rogers. Gabby introduced Mr. Blackton to the lady.
Is this a joke? You mean that's Rodney Blackton?
That's right. I'm his guardian.
Oh, then you're Sylvia Clark.
Yes, I wired you, remember?
Welcome to the West, Miss Clark. I'm your next-door neighbor.
How do you do?
Vera, don't you think you better show the new owner to his room?
Why, yes, it's right upstairs.
My name's Jackson, Greg Jackson. How about a drink, boys?
Fine.
Just a minute, boys. No thanks, Mr. Jackson. We have an appointment in town.
That ain't true, Roy. We ain't it yet. He ain't gonna throw that beef out, is he?
Oh, I'm sorry. I should have asked you. You're hungry. Sam, put it back. Rustle up some potatoes. Come on, boys. Get it while it's hot.
Now, wait a minute, boys. You think Miss Martin will mind?
Oh, not a bit of it. Come on, grab yourself a seat, Rogers.
I can't believe it.
Disappointed?
Yes, a little. I didn't realize the place was so run down.
I've done everything I could since Mr. Bagley died, Miss Clark, but it's an awful burden.
Excuse me. I'd like to thank you folks for the dinner, and I guess the boys and I'll be shoving along.
Oh, no, Roger, sit down. You're a Western boy. Perhaps you can help me convince Miss Clark that her best bet is to sell this place. I made her an offer, but she's not quite sure of herself.
Well, you see, I'm terribly green. Mr. Jackson seems to think it's hopeless for me to try and run it.
Why is it hopeless?
Well, it's practically bankrupt. The water's dried up. Worst of all, there's no stock left.
No stock at all?
No, not a head. All wanted off, I guess. Why do you ask?
Because coming over here this evening, I saw herd being driven off of this property. Some of them were wearing a Bagley brand, Triple X.
Oh, they must be those stragglers, Greg. They don't amount to much. Besides, you'd have to work them, Miss Clark. That takes men. I had to let all our hands go today. It really wouldn't pay you.
Not worth bothering with.
What do you think, Roy?
Well, I think you ought to keep it. The cattle look good to me. As for men, well, the boys and I haven't a thing to do.
Oh, that's awfully nice of you, but I don't know how I could pay you.
You can pay us later. Sorry to disagree with you, Jackson, but you asked my opinion.
Well, you're making it a little tough for me, Rogers. I didn't want to bring this up, but I have a note here for $5,000. Bagley gave it to me for watering his stock after his water dried up. It's payable at once. It's all quite legal. You can read it over later, Miss Clark.
$5,000?
Mr. Jackson's been awfully nice about it, Miss Clark. He hasn't pressed me in the least.
I'm willing to continue to be nice about it. I don't want to embarrass you. I might extend it a little. 2 weeks. But I can't continue that indefinitely. I'd like you to think it over pretty carefully, Miss Clark. You think it over too, Rogers. And keep one thing in mind. You can't run a ranch on good intentions. There are a lot of angles that don't meet the eye sometimes.
That's why I told Miss Clark not to sell Jackson.
Well, come on, girl.
Excuse me, please.
We only have 2 weeks. Will you trust me?
Oh, I trust you. It isn't that. It's just that I don't understand.
Well, that's just the point. It doesn't make sense. And it never will till we find some of the answers that are missing tonight.
Well, if you're willing to try it, I don't see why I shouldn't do my part. Shall we shake on it?
Miss Clark, you've made a deal. We'll straighten the rest out in the morning. Maybe I'll have some of those missing answers then.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to find that herd, and if they're yours, we'll round them up right now, tonight. Hey, Pat, would you and the boys like to take a little ride? Gabby, get your face out of that pie, will you?
How do you like that guy? What's he doing out in the range this time of night?
Probably looking for cattle. Only he won't find any.
Reminds me, Bart hasn't checked in. I better ride over and take a look myself.
This is going to be our busy night.
We'll give them a surprise.
There they are, Gabby. Down there. Triple X, all right.
Boy, that's a break. Let's take them back, Roy.
Come on, boys. We'll smoke them out. Keep them busy. I'll go around behind them.
Wait a minute. I've got an idea. We'll stampede the herd. Give me a hand.
Avalanche! Every man for himself!
Was hijacking the herd.
They're not hijacking. The law's on their side. Come on, get out of here, quick.
By golly, they're leaving. How's that for showing them, son? That's what I call easy work.
A little too easy, Gabby.
Well, what do you think, Roy?
I think we better find that herd.
That's a big order, ain't it? After those rocks sent them scooting, they're halfway to Kalamazoo, I'll bet you.
All right, I'll take that bet.
Pretty good guess, Maroy. There they be.
Ain't our property. Look.
It's Jackson's place.
There's no trespassing, don't it?
Cows can't read, Gabby, but they sure go for that water.
Hey, boys, cut that wire fence.
Roy, somebody's coming.
Looks like Jackson. Let me handle this.
Hello, Rogers. Kind of late to be visiting, isn't it? It happened to be my property, you know.
So I noticed. We were on our way home, had some trouble with some rustlers back on the range a ways.
Rustlers, huh? You sure?
I'm positive. You must have heard the shooting. They were running off our stock.
Oh, now I know you're kidding. You haven't got any stock, Rogers. Frankly, I'm a little surprised. Thought you weren't a drinking man.
I'm not, but what I said still goes, and I say that we're rustlers.
All right, have it your own way. It doesn't matter to me. Get some of the hands. We're moving that herd back to our corral. Mind if we go to work?
Not a bit. Matter of fact, we'll help you. You run them through the fence, and we'll take over from there.
You what?
You heard me, Jackson. Those are the cattle you said were stragglers. But good or bad, they don't belong to you. Take a look at the brand. Yes, I know what you're going to say. The water's yours.
You're getting warm. It's not free, either.
All right, put it on the bill. We already owe you $5,000. A few more gallon won't make any difference. All right, boys, get them moving.
Now, listen, Rogers. What makes you think you can dish out orders on my property? If I make any deals, it'll be with the owner, not with a two-bit tramp.
All right, make them with the owner. Here she comes now.
Hello? Hello, Greg. We heard shots. What's going on?
I wouldn't know. Ask Rogers.
Are those our cattle, Roy?
Well, there seems to be some dispute about it. But they all have the Triple X brand on them. I'm sure glad you came down, Miss Clark. Mr. Jackson here wants to make a deal with you.
Oh, I don't want to sell. I appreciate the offer, though.
Oh, it isn't that. Your stock has been watering on my ranch. Rogers here feels that I ought to donate the service.
I told him you'd pay for it. Put it on your note.
Well, is that satisfactory, Mr. Jackson?
Oh, that's all right with me. If you'd asked me in the first place, Miss Clark, there wouldn't have been any argument.
Oh, thanks a lot. You're very kind. Are you going back to the ranch, Roy?
Sure, I'll ride along with you.
You go ahead. I'll catch up with you later. Certainly messed things up tonight.
Beat it. Doesn't matter. We'll get them back with interest.
Not if they find a buyer. They'll pay off that note, and then where will we be?
Oh, so that's it. I thought I told you to forget about that
Listen,
note.
Listen, Greg, that's forgery. If they find out, we'll
They won't. There's no danger of them raising enough money to pay it off, either. Now, why don't you let me handle this my way? The property will be ours in 2 weeks. I guarantee it.
More ideas, Greg?
Pretty good, too. I'll drop over in the morning and tell you about them.
Good morning. Can I see you a minute?
Roy, I'm glad you came. I want you to look at something. I'm not very good at arithmetic. Will you please check these figures?
Well, they seem to add up all right. 50 head at $100 a head. Say, that makes our $5,000.
Yes, but you're overlooking something. 2 weeks. Can we find a buyer in 2 weeks?
Well, I think I've already found him. Here, read this. Feel better?
A lot better. But why didn't Jackson tell us about this? He must have known it.
He knows plenty, Sylvia, and we're catching on fast. Remember what he said last night?
You mean about angles that don't meet the eye?
Exactly. So keep yours open. Stick around, boys. I'll be right out.
Some job. I don't mind doing a gal a favor, but all we do is ride. Burning up good energy and saddle leather.
You've been burning up her food, too, ain't you? Why, you're gorged to the gills right now.
All he can hear is the dinner bell. Two helpings of stew he had, and last night I saw him take a whole pie and hide it in the garbage chute.
Oh, I never did. Garbage chute? I thought that was a cooler.
Would you ring Mr. Sheldon, please?
Clifford Sheldon?
Yes, sir.
You'll find him in the bar, last table over.
All right, thanks.
Mr. Sheldon?
Yes?
My name's Rogers.
How are you?
Don't serve milk here, Rogers. The boys' department's downstairs.
I represent the Bagley Ranch. I understand you're looking for some cattle.
Yes, I am. Sit down, won't you?
Thanks.
Well, if you don't mind, we'll finish our little deal later.
Suit yourself, Jackson. Here's your binder, though. Have the stock at the railhead in the morning, and you can pick up the balance. That's 150 head, right?
That's right. Don't worry, they'll be there.
Oh, did you say the Bagley Ranch?
Yes, sir.
Well, you must be a neighbor of Jackson's, aren't you?
The next ranch. But we're not very neighborly, though. I suppose you noticed that.
Funny thing. I talked to him. He said that most of your stock had wandered off.
Well, he's wrong. We've got 50 head. Well, you don't have to take my word for it. I'd like you to go out and take a look for yourself if you're interested. You busy?
Well, not particularly. No, I could ride out with you right now if you got an extra horse.
Well, that's fine. The sooner the better.
Okay. Well, I guess I better get out of these city duds. Only take me about a minute to change. I'll meet you outside. Hmm?
All right.
Was that necessary?
What? Oh, I'm sorry.
Careful, boys. We don't want no trouble in here.
Just an apology. How about it, Jackson?
Why, glad to, Rogers. By George, isn't that a shame? Look at that. All over his nice, clean britches. Look, Bart.
I can't see.
Nobody knows. She's my only Colleen. We're wedding today. I'm changing her name to Mavourneen O'Shea.
Oh, Mavourneen O'Shea. Her name sounds better that way. Kathy is fine and O'Hara's okay, but none half so fine as Mavourneen O'Shea.
She's happy, I know, for she told me today she will be changing her name to O'Shea, and soon we'll be having some kids who can say, I'm happy to meet you, my name is O'Shea.
Oh, Mavourneen O'Shea, her name sounds better that way. Kathy is fine and O'Hara's okay, but none's half so fine as Mavourneen O'Shea.
What's going on here? Who started this, Jackson?
This fellow, this Rogers here, Sheriff. He took a poke at Bart, then his hoodlums moved in on my men. Almost killed poor Bart.
Somebody's got to pay for this mess. Looks like it's your move, stranger.
Not me, Sheriff. Jackson here's got his stories mixed.
There's your man. I saw the whole thing.
Do you know anything about this, Mr. Sheldon?
Why, yes, I saw part of it, Sheriff. I think maybe I can clear it up for you. Tell him, bartender. Go ahead.
It's Mr. Jackson. I guess his foot kind of slipped and he sort of tripped him. These other fellas was just defending their pal.
That's right. Rogers came in here and he was minding his own business.
Oh.
You don't want to call Mr. Sheldon a liar, do you, Jackson?
Well, no. I'll pay up the freight, but only because somebody has to. I know this Rogers is stone broke. Send me a bill.
Thanks a lot, Mr. Sheldon.
That's all right, Rogers.
You boys ready?
Sheriff, these are for you.
Thank you, Mr. Sheldon.
In the interest of justice, of course.
Thank heaven for them bills, Miss Clark. You don't know what a strain it is, fighting 11 men on an empty stomach. Excuse me, I'm a little faint. You don't mind if I help myself? Boy, what a fight I put up. You ought to have been there, Miss Clark. I must have been every place at once. A darting and a grappling, I was quicker than a range ferret. And that finish? Told, 'twas glorious.
Oh, how do you know how it ended? You were so scared you couldn't see. Well, will you look at this, boys? That's where I was going. In Gabby.
Yeah, and it's got to stop. What do you think we ought to do with him?
Well, we can boil him down for his essential juices, maybe. You know, turning cannibal is the only way we're going to get a square meal around here.
Oh, stop it, boys. Heroes got to eat.
Gabby, you said Mr. Sheldon was interested in our herd. Do you think he'll take all of them?
Why not? He's our pal now. After Roy gets through showing him around, he'll do anything we say. You know, it ain't always cows makes the world go round. Personality.
Or pie, if you can get it.
Heard you all talking about food and decided it was his dinner time, too.
He's right. I'll get his bottle.
No. Let me do it. You sit right there. You know, that little baby and me is chums.
Jumping, T-Hawks, the fanny's foundered himself. This has happened before, Miss Clark. Too many groceries and no sense.
He'll be all right later. We'll just put him under the pump and then lay him out in the sun for a couple hours.
Another slab of pie, boys. That's a great thing, Brady.
Oh, that must be Roy, Mr. Sheldon. Will you clean up those dishes, Vera?
Yes.
Well, Miss Clark, your boy here didn't misrepresent anything. I'm taking the whole herd off your hands.
Oh, that's good news, Mr. Sheldon.
May I use your pen a minute? There you are. Cash in advance. You have that stock at the station by 10 in the morning, Roy.
Don't you worry, Mr. Sheldon. We'll keep our end of the bargain. Sylvia, I think this calls for a speech of thanks.
Why, not at all. It was worth it for the show alone. I'll never forget the expression on Jackson's face when he slid down that piano. And that melody you boys sang when he passed out. It was first-rate singing, Miss Clark.
I have an idea, Roy. Let's have a party for Mr. Sheldon to celebrate the deal. We ought to get acquainted with our neighbors. Will you stay over?
Well, I don't know, Miss Clark. I really ought to be heading east tomorrow.
Well, what about tonight, Sylvia? You can invite the guests, and I'll have the boys fix the place up party style.
Well, it's up to the guest of honor. The pleasure'd be all ours, Mr. Sheldon.
Well, I don't know about that. Well, the answer is yes, Miss Clark. Keep them singing, Roy. It's a date.
Why, I'd rather sleep than eat my fill.
He's an old good son of a gun.
So I got me a job with the cattle crew, and the boss said, son, I'm going to fire you, so I guess that's just what he'll have to do.
He's an old good son of a gun.
Oh, here comes. Just taking my time.
Taking his time. He's a lazy rambling, rolling, gambling, old good son of a gun.
Oh, there must be some place I can go.
He's an old good son of a gun.
Where the rain don't fall and there ain't no snow.
He's an old good son of a gun.
Where the rooster wakes with a cock-a-doodle-doo and he says there's lots of nothing to do and the whole darn crew's gonna help me, too.
He's an old good son of a gun.
Oh, here it comes.
Here it comes.
Just taking my time.
Taking his time. He's a lazy rambling, rolling, gambling, old good son of a gun. He's an old good son of a gun.
Oh, here it comes.
Here it comes.
Just taking my time.
Taking his time. He's a lazy rambling, rolling, gambling, old good son of a gun.
Who, me?
Yes, you.
Well, I'm a no good son of a gun.
Gabby's stealing our pies.
Yeah, and drop whatever you're doing and run down here, even if you're asleep.
I got the tarn feathers out in the barn. I got to hand it to you, Pat. We have our pie and eat it, too, besides teaching Gabby a lesson. Say, you don't suppose we've got too many batteries? We don't want to kill him, do we?
It don't matter. Pie stealing's just as bad as cattle rustling. And I'm through starving so that shaggy old moose can stagger through life eating six men's dessert. Ready, Bob?
All set.
Where's Gabby?
Eating our pie. That's a signal. Make tracks. We're too late. Ain't that disgusting? He eat himself silly again.
Now, wait a minute, Pat. There's something wrong here. They're all there, all five pies.
Oh. I've been hit by a tree. Cattle thieves. They stole our cows. Well, don't stand there gaping. They stole our herd.
Georgie's right. The corral's empty. Where'd they go?
Down the valley. Way down.
I'll get Roy. Come on, we'll get the horses, Tim.
Roy! What's wrong? Somebody's rustled off the herd and they're heading down the valley.
Well, let's go.
Boys, come on!
Boys.
What's the trouble?
Cattle thieves. Your cattle, Mr. Sheldon.
Sheriff, we may need some help.
Right away. Please be careful.
Did you find out who did it, Miss Clark?
Nothing yet. Are you going with them?
Why not? I've got a stake in this, too.
With the truck. We can't chase them on that pavement.
Yeah, it looks like we lost that round.
Maybe. You better start looking for that gang on the horses.
Well, those are truck tracks, all right. That's one way to rustle cattle. Horse flesh is okay, but gasoline's quicker. You'll never be able to catch them on the highway.
How can you be so sure they want to? None of my affair, Mr. Sheldon, but it does seem strange to me, cash in advance for cows that disappear all of a sudden.
Well, you're not inferring that Roy would rustle my stock, are you?
Well, I'm not inferring anything. Only I think you were a little hasty writing that check. You see, I happen to know how broke this ranch really is. They're pretty desperate.
You seem to know all their business, Miss Martin.
I do, and I'm honestly sorry for the girl. She got stung on this place. First the stream's dried up, now the stock's gone. It's a tough break.
Awfully tough. Yes, I heard about that water situation. Funny thing, too, that stream drying up.
Yes, wasn't it? Well, I guess we might as well be going back. We can't do any more good here.
Well, you ride on ahead. I think I'll scout around a little. Maybe I can find out where that truck came from. The trail leads right up that canyon.
It's awfully late to be riding that trail alone, Mr. Sheldon. Why don't you wait till morning?
Well, I'm going east tomorrow. See you at the ranch house later, Miss Martin.
Any luck, Vera?
Afraid not. Whoever it was used a truck. Have you called the sheriff?
Yes, he's on his way. I'll call his office. Maybe the police can trace that truck.
No, wait a minute, dear. You say goodbye to your guests. I'll go.
If we can do anything, Miss Clark, let us know. We know just how you feel. It was a swell party anyway.
Thank you. Good night, Mr. Langdon.
Good night.
Good night. I'm glad you could all come.
I just left him. Yes, out in range. He found those tire tracks. Listen, Greg, I don't know what's happened, but Sheldon's suspicious. He's following those tracks up Grace Canyon, supposing he finds the dam. That's what I'm trying to tell you. We've got to stop him. All right, but hurry. If he ever talks with...
Oh, I was just calling the sheriff. You're lying. I heard what you said. You and Jackson have been cheating us. I should have known before. Get away from that phone.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to stop Jackson from adding murder to your other crimes.
We got here, a sassy young gal with a shooting iron.
Oh! Gabby, lock her in the closet, hurry! Here, hurry up.
Glory be, I'm fine.
Listen, Gabby, I've got to find Sheldon before Jackson does. He's in Grace Canyon. They might kill him, do you understand?
Kill him? But what's
I haven't got time to explain now. Just call the sheriff and tell him what I told you. Grace Canyon, have you got it?
Let me see now. Sheldon, Jackson, Grace Canyon, call the sheriff. Yep, I'm all set. Where's that fool talking about?
It's right over there. Hurry and find Roy, will you? Hurry, Gabby.
Hello.
Get the door! Get me out of here!
Oh, Sheriff. No, no, not you. Give me the sheriff. Oh, I ain't got no time to apologize now. The sheriff, yeah, that's what I said. Talk to you. They're murdering Sheldon up in Grace Canyon. I got the gal locked up and the sheriff's coming. Oh, stand still, critter. I'm doing some talking here.
But that don't make sense. Who's murdering Sheldon?
It's Jackson. Miss Clark's going to warn him. Oh, I wonder if I've got it right this time. Should I say it again?
No, that makes sense. Grace Canyon, boys, and don't let the death bother
you.
Sheriff.
Mr. Sheldon! Where are you, Mr. Sheldon? Where are you, Mr. Sheldon?
Listen.
Mr. Sheldon!
Sounds like that Clark girl. Up here.
I don't think that concerns you, does it?
It might. Who told you Sheldon was here?
Sheldon? Oh, I don't know, is he? Excuse me.
You were just calling him. Don't try to kid me. Somebody's coming, Greg. Hello, Sheldon.
Oh, it's you, Jackson.
Exploring?
Well, as a matter of fact, I was. There's a dam up the canyon a ways. Ever seen it?
A dam? You must be mistaken.
Oh, no. It's there, all right. You wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
What's on your mind?
That's far enough, Jackson.
All right, men.
Now, take it easy. He might be faking. Sheldon or not. But if he opens his yap about that dam, we're in a nasty spot. Now, you and Jeff and Monty get up there and blow it. There's some dynamite left in the cache. You understand?
You flood the canyon? What about the boys?
Forget the boys. I'm thinking about us now.
Well, she can talk, too.
I'll take care of Miss Clark. I'll meet you in the usual place. Go on, get going.
He must still be in the canyon then.
Here. I'll see you later.
Thank you.
you, Roy. Boy, am I hungry. What's it say?
Well, it's for Mr. Sheldon. They found the truck.
Hooray for Sheriff Preston's. I better go tell the boys.
What about our stock, Roy?
You mean Mr. Sheldon's stock. They found every head and they're shipping the whole herd east from Mesa City.
Oh, I don't know what to say. If I have to go through this every time we sell cattle, I better take up something less exciting, like housekeeping or...
raising babies? maybe you could do both.